Now, we will be initiating a discussion on another important topic, that is the emergency provisions. The Constitution provides for three types of emergencies: national emergency, state emergency, and financial emergency. And financial emergency. National emergency is to be proclaimed under Article 352. The grounds can be war or external aggression or armed rebellion. State emergency can be proclaimed under Article 356. The ground: breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state. Financial emergency is to be proclaimed under Article 360. If the financial stability or credibility of India or of any part thereof is threatened. This is our synopsis for the emergency provisions. This aspect is important from the prelims point of view, and in the examination, we can expect two types of statements. One, the procedure of the proclamation of the emergencies, and secondly, the effects of such emergencies. Now we will be taking up for discussion the various types of emergencies one by one, that what is the procedure and what are the effects. First of all, coming to the national emergency. Grounds we have written: war, external aggression, or armed rebellion. Now coming to the procedure, how the national emergency can be proclaimed. First, the president can proclaim national emergency. The president can proclaim national emergency on the written advice of the cabinet. On the written advice of the cabinet. Next, the president's proclamation has to be approved within 1 month by a majority of not less than 2/3 of the members present and voting. Not less than 2/3 of the members present and voting, and the absolute majority of both the houses of the parliament, underlined 1 month. So if the national emergency is not approved by the parliament by a special majority within 1 month, then it will cease to operate and it will be discontinued. Thirdly, the approval of the parliament is valid only for 6 months at a time. Underline 6 months. So after every 6 months, the national emergency has to be extended by the parliament by the special majority. If not, then the national emergency will be discontinued. How many times it can extend, it all depends on the circumstances, and that is why the constitution is silent on that. In India, the national emergency has been proclaimed thrice. First, October 1962 to 1968. First of all, we had a war with China, and secondly, we had a war with Pakistan. So it was on the ground of external aggression and war. Then, December 3rd, 1971 to March 1977, we had a war with Pakistan, and when this emergency was going on, another emergency was proclaimed in the country. It was June 25th, 1975 to March 1977. June 25th, 1975 to March 1977, it was on the ground of internal disturbance. It was on the ground of internal disturbance. Now, some of you may be thinking that when one emergency was going on, what was the need for another emergency in the month of June 1975? Basically, there is a procedure that we follow during national emergency, that as soon as the national emergency is proclaimed on the grounds of war or external aggression, Article 19 is automatically suspended. And what the president can do, by a separate proclamation, on that day only, he can suspend our other fundamental rights. It is not that the national emergency has been proclaimed today and after 1 year, our other fundamental rights will be suspended. It cannot be done. Now, in 1971, we had a war with Pakistan, the story we had discussed. And normalcy had returned in India. We had a Shimla Agreement and there was peace. But the government of the day did not advise the president to discontinue the national emergency. The national emergency continued. And during national emergency, our Article 19 was suspended. People waited that when the national emergency will be discontinued, but nothing happened. On April 24th, 1975, from the historic Gandhi Maidan of Patna, there started a movement called Total Revolution, Sampurna Kranti, and it was popularly known as JP Movement. Jayaprakash Narayan was the leader, JP Movement. It was a non-violent revolution against the autocratic regime of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Against the dictatorship of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, the youths were mostly the participants of the total revolution. They used to cover their mouth with saffron clothes and they used to tie their hands and they used to keep them at back and used to walk on the streets, symbolizing that in this country, we don't have freedom of speech and expression and we are not free. Mrs. Indira Gandhi did not hear to all these things. But meanwhile, the judgment of the Allahabad High Court came, which declared the election of Mrs. Indira Gandhi to the Lok Sabha as null and void. Raj Narayan had challenged the election of Mrs. Indira Gandhi to the Lok Sabha and the election was declared as null and void by the Allahabad High Court. Now the opposition became aggressive that this lady had not won the election in a fair way. Her election has been declared as null and void and she has proclaimed the national emergency and she is not discontinuing it. The opposition combinedly started demanding the resignation of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Agitations across the country and all the opposition leaders, they came to Delhi and they surrounded the house of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. They sat there that we will not allow you to come outside the house if you will not resign. Will not allow you to function as the Prime Minister of this country. Mrs. Indira Gandhi took her official phone and telephoned Fakhruddin Ali Ahmad Sahab, who was the president of India. That, sir, proclaim emergency in the country. He said, ma'am, we are already having an emergency. What is the need of that? She said, people have become very, we can say, too much free in this country. We need to curb their freedom. You see, they are sitting outside my house. They have curtailed my freedom. He asked, ma'am, on what grounds? She said, internal disturbance. And she said that you suspend all the fundamental rights, including right to life and right to personal liberty of the citizens of India. And it was done. As soon as the president's proclamation came, all the opposition leaders were arrested. Because your right to personal liberty was suspended. Then arrests took place across the country. Anyone who was ideologically attached or ideologically against the Congress, he was arrested. Schools, colleges, they were made makeshift jails. And one of my very senior colleagues in my college, he remembered the emergency days and you said, you cannot imagine those days. I said, sir, what happened? He said that in the public place, they used to shout in plain clothes, "Oye master, oye master." And anyone who used to turn back was arrested. Master means teacher. Teacher and ideologue. So anyone, obviously, who used to be a teacher, he used to turn back and he was arrested. Whenever the people used to see the police, they used to run and they used to hide in the, we can say, some trees or here and there. Why? Forced family planning. How many kids you have? Two. Chalo, come. Family planning. Clear? So basically, it was the government's way of controlling the population of India. In March 1977, the election took place. The national emergency was discontinued and Mrs. Indira Gandhi lost the elections and the Janata Party came to power. And a political party, if it comes to power, first of all, it tries to unmake the law according to which they were tortured. So the 44th Amendment Act was passed and a major change was made in Article 352. So there is a relationship between 44th Amendment Act and Article 352. So if there is a relation, we also need to write it. You can write it. The 44th Amendment Act, 1978. The 44th Amendment Act, 1978, and Article 352. And Article 352. First, the expression internal disturbance was replaced by a more concrete expression that is armed rebellion. Internal disturbance is a very vague term. Or disturbance is a very vague term. Even if you smile in the class, I can say, why are you disturbing the class? I do not say this. I say only when it disturbs a lot. Clear. It affects me. Then only I say. Otherwise, I do not say. I myself smile and I love smiling people. So, but even if someone smiles in the class, I'll say, why are you disturbing? It is a very vague term. So more concrete expression was put. That is armed rebellion. Secondly, the national emergency to be proclaimed by the president on the written advice of the cabinet. So we may have discussed earlier that the term, the word cabinet is there only under Article 352, and it was added by the 44th Amendment Act 1978. Next. The Parliament's approval has to be within one month by a special majority. Earlier, the approval was to be within two months and by a simple majority. Next, the approval of the Parliament to be valid only for six months at a time. Earlier, no such provision was there. Next, the fundamental rights under Article 19. To be automatically suspended only when the national emergency was proclaimed on the grounds of war or external aggression. So before this Amendment Act, even if the national emergency was to be proclaimed on any other ground, then Article 19 was to be automatically suspended. Next. Under Article 359, Articles 20 and 21 cannot be suspended during national emergency. So earlier, the president was authorized to suspend all the fundamental rights, including Articles 20 as well as 21. But now Articles 20 and 21 cannot be suspended. Next. The Lok Sabha in a special session. The Lok Sabha in a special session can suspend can pass a resolution to discontinue an ongoing national emergency. Earlier, no such clause was there. We had discussed that a special session of the Lok Sabha can be summoned on the request of 1/10 of the members of the house. And in that special session, the Lok Sabha can pass a resolution to discontinue an ongoing national emergency. Now coming to the effects of national emergency. Effects of national emergency. First, effects on center-state relations. The distribution of powers between the center and the states is suspended. And the parliament can make a law on any subject in the state list. Then, effect on the legislature. The term of the Lok Sabha and the legislative assemblies can be extended for not more than one year at a time. Next, effects on the fundamental rights. Please refer to our earlier discussion. We had discussed twice that under Article 358, there is automatic suspension of Article 19 when the national emergency is proclaimed on the grounds of war or external aggression. And then under Article 359, the president may by a separate proclamation can suspend all other fundamental rights except those under Articles 20 and 21. These were the things that we needed to discuss under national emergency. Coming to the state emergency. When we talk about the statement of article number 356, article 356 says that if the president, either on the receipt of the report of the governor or otherwise, if the president either on the receipt of a report from the governor or otherwise is satisfied that a situation has arisen in which the administration of the state cannot be run on the basis of this constitution, he can make a proclamation to that effect. Underline either on the receipt of the governor or otherwise. So even by any other source, the president will come to know that there is a breakdown of constitutional machinery. Obviously, he will issue a proclamation to that effect. Now, coming to the meaning of the breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state, because it is a vague term. What can be the exact conditions of the president's rule? You may note it. What can be termed as breakdown of constitutional machinery? First, if no government formation is possible in the state, secondly, if a state government fails to abide by the administrative directives given by the center, in bracket you write according to article 365. So this we had discussed in the last class only, that if a state government fails to abide by the administrative directives, it can be considered as breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state. And thirdly, in the S.R. Bommai case, In the S.R. Bommai case, 1994, the Supreme Court held that secularism is one of the basic structures of the Constitution. And if a state government, fails to abide by, it, or is unable to protect it, or subverts it, then it has to be considered as, breakdown of constitutional machinery in the state. You say that three reasons. One, the political reason. Second, the constitutional reason. And third, a judicial pronouncement. Once in the main examination, they had asked this question, that what can be the grounds of president's rule in the state? In the prelims examination also, there can be such type of statements. Which of the following statements are correct regarding the ground of president's rule? Now coming to the procedure. Basically, after the demolition of the Babri Mosque, in 1992, we had this judgment, but the SR Bommai case was related to the president's rule in Karnataka. But as the judgment came in 1994, the Supreme Court looked into some other aspects also, which can be one of the conditions of president's rule. Now, coming to the procedure. The president's proclamation has to be approved by the parliament, within two months by a simple majority, underline 2 months. Next, the approval of the parliament shall be valid only for 6 months at a time. Next, it can be extended for another 6 months. So 6 months plus 6 months, 1 year. So under normal conditions, the president rule or the state emergency cannot go beyond 1 year. But if the state emergency is to be extended beyond 1 year, it has to be on two conditions. You may note it. Then it has to be on two conditions. It has to be on two conditions. First, if the national emergency, is going on in the country, or in any part, and secondly, the Election Commission, has shown its inability, to conduct elections, under the prevailing situations, So both the conditions have to be fulfilled. Suppose if the national emergency is going on and if the Election Commission says, no, we will conduct elections, we will be able to conduct elections, then the state emergency will not continue beyond 1 year. Elections have to be held in that state. But if the Election Commission says that as the national emergency is going on, we'll not be able to conduct the elections, then only the state emergency can be extended beyond 1 year. These two conditions have to be fulfilled. But under these conditions also, the state emergency cannot be extended beyond 2 years. You may note it. Under these conditions, the state emergency cannot continue beyond 2 years but it can be extended only for 6 months at a time. So it will be 6 months plus 6 months, 6 months plus 6 months, 2 years. It becomes a question of your prelims examination that what will be the maximum period of state emergency under the Constitution of India? The answer will be 3 years. One under normal circumstances, two under abnormal circumstances. In the next sentence you write, if the state emergency, is to continue beyond 3 years, Constitution has to be amended. So, during militancy in Punjab, the state emergency was extended again and again every 6 months, and Constitution was amended because the emergency continued for more than 5 years. So every 6 months, Article 356 was amended. Now here I refer to a case, S.R. Bommai case. This case is a landmark case regarding article number 356. S.R. Bommai was the chief minister of Karnataka and he was leading a coalition government, and 10 Janata Dal members, the MLAs, they took the support from the government. the governor did not give chance to S.R. Bommai to prove his majority in the Vidhan Sabha, and the president rule was proclaimed. And S.R. Bommai went to the Supreme Court against the president's rule. Before this, there was an apprehension in the minds of the people that this is under the discretionary power of the governor and the president's rule is not subject to judicial review. But in the S.R. Bommai case, the Supreme Court gave a landmark judgment that the president's rule is subject to judicial review. So S.R. Bommai case is important case from the viewpoint of Article 356, as it was against the misuse of the power by the center. What was the judgment? You may write it. S.R. Bommai case. First, the president's proclamation is subject to judicial review. Secondly, the responsibility of providing the relevant documents lies with the center. So the central government will have to furnish the documents on the basis of which the president rule has been proclaimed. And thirdly, if the court is satisfied that the state emergency has been proclaimed, On illogical grounds, or is politically motivated, the court has the power to declare the state emergency as invalid and to restore the government even if the election process has been initiated in the state. So that is why the S.R. Bommai case is considered to be a landmark case in regard to article number 356. Now coming to the last part, that is effects of the state emergency. There is no effect on our fundamental rights. We are not aware about it. Basically, it is the government which is affected. First, the Council of Ministers is dismissed. Next, the Legislative Assembly, can be either dissolved or can be kept under suspended animation So dissolve means we'll have fresh elections within 6 months, the MLAs will lose their job. Suspended animation means the MLAs will be there. As the government is not there, we cannot have the meetings or the sessions of the assembly. Next. The president can take over the powers vested in all the organs of the government except that of the High Court. So the president will not assume the judicial powers, but he will be assuming all the executive and legislative powers. And the laws of that state will be made by the parliament. So parliament will be authorized to make laws on the subjects in the state list for that particular state. These were the aspects that we needed to discuss under the state emergency.
Now coming to financial emergency. Financial emergency. What our constitution says, what was the ground that we had written? Let me one page, let's just see it. You have an idea. If the financial stability or credibility of India or of any part thereof is threatened, credibility of India. What is this credibility? If our foreign exchange reserves have ceased to exist, ya bahut kam ho gaya hai, we have borrowed, we can say, from the other countries, but we have no foreign exchange to give them back. So it is a type of credibility. Aur ek word kya likha hum logon ne? And stability. Obviously, if our expenses are more than our income, we are not able to manage the various developmental works. So at that point of time, the financial emergency can be proclaimed. This is what has been written. Now coming to the procedure, how it is proclaimed. How it is? Okay. The President's proclamation has to be approved by the Parliament within two months by a simple majority here the 6 months clause is not there. So once it is proclaimed, it will continue till the president will not revoke it or will not discontinue it. कोई सिक्स मंथ्स का चक्कर नहीं है. वंस इट इज अप्रूव्ड इट विल कंटिन्यू टिल द प्रेसिडेंट विल नॉट डिसकंटिन्यू इट. देन अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग हियर इज दैट द फाइनेंशियल इमरजेंसी ऑटोमेटिकली कम्स टू एन एंड ऑन द डेट ऑफ द एंड ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल ईयर, दैट इज ऑन 31st March. सो इवन इफ द फाइनेंशियल इमरजेंसी हैज बीन प्रोक्लेम्ड, on 10th of March, it will be automatically discontinued on 31st of March. Because aapka jo bhi budgetary allocations hai, that can be made, and in the next financial year, you can enter with all the adjustments that is required in your economy. Ye toh na zindagi bhar tak chalo, you can have the financial emergency. So, when you will have the new budget, accordingly you can make arrangements to meet the situation. That is what is understood here. Now coming to the effects. The effects. There may be a provision. There may be a provision that all the money bills and financial bills passed by a state legislature passed by a state legislature must be reserved by the governor for the reconsideration of the president. So along with the proclamation of the president regarding financial emergency, there can be a provision there that all the money bills and financial bills passed by the state legislature, they must be reserved by the governor for the reconsideration of the president. There may be such type of, because the central government gives the resources to the states in the form of grand seed. So when we do not have money in the country, and under what expenses you are using that money or misusing that money, the president should look into it. Secondly, there may be a provision. There may be a provision that, there may be a provision regarding the curtailment of salaries and allowances. Some section of officials, including the judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts. So you say our constitution has clearly written that there may be curtailment of salary, there may be a provision in the proclamation regarding the curtailment of the salary and allowances of all or some section of the officials, including the judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts. और किसी के बारे में नहीं लिखा, including president, prime minister, governor नहीं लिखा, but they wrote that it is including the judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts. मतलब सोचो, judiciary को भी वो लोग risk नहीं लेना चाहते थे, because these people, the judges, they are the interpreters of the constitution. Now, if उनकी salary कर कटी है, they can interpret, hey, it is written officials. We are not officials, we are the judges. Clear? So basically, you say the mechanism which has been provided. No doubt some of our provisions may be outdated. But yes, our constitution makers, they looked into such aspects in minute detail. Up in the prelims examination, the question can be, which of the following statements are correct? And in place of including, they may have used the word excluding. So excited nahi hona ke hum to malum hai aur karke excluding bhi rahega to you will answer ke that option. It is not like that, we call it as human error. Jyadatar bachchon ke politics answer isi mein galat hote hain because they feel that we know it. They do not read the whole sentence. So it is including, it will not be excluding. No financial emergency has been proclaimed in the country till date, and with the hope that there will be no financial emergency in the future also, we'll stop our discussion on the emergency provisions. This was the emergency provisions. Jitne bhi cheeze maine aapko bataya, procedure and effect, that is important from the prelims point of view.